Alright, so I'm just gonna continue where I left off playing this. And, well, I have not seen this in a while. And I also need to check the controls, because I forgot what I had it set for 64 games. Let's see.
Am I still cutting in and out?
Nah, you're good. You haven't cut in and out pretty much at all this stream, so that's pretty good.
Weird.
I don't even remember the controls for this. I think I have that though. I also put save states on this, just because I didn't feel like playing this legitimately at all.
Oh, so it's, you're not even gonna start the game.
Yeah, I'm not even at the start of the game. I'm just gonna... Do I have the state separate? Let me look at it. I'll get it to the start of the game just so you can see the, truly memorable cutscene at the beginning.
Okay, why does the graphics suck?
Even
Zelda 64, like the beta version looked like it, they made things try to look good.
Yeah, right. So this area actually looks worse than a lot of the areas I've seen so far. Except for the forest area, that's definitely worse.
Right.
But the courtyard area of this game, which when I just get a new save file. Also note that this really ugly pink artifacting around this text is not in the game. This is just a byproduct of the emulator.
It's just a glitch.
Yeah. This freaking molasses smeared cabbage ground that we have going on here is terrible. Yes, indeed. But there are locations that look better than this. I don't even know why they thought this was a good
idea. The grass sucks.
Yeah.
The walls, like that mountain in the distance, and right there, also sucks. Why is it green?
I have no...
Or better yet, the water also looks pretty crappy.
Yeah, like, the graphics in this game... Like, there's a few things that look good. Like, this bridge looks fine. I mean, this is a nice bridge,
it's
I guess.
Enough.
But then you have the terrain, and the way it's built in this game makes me just... Oh my gosh. I don't even know what they were thinking for half... I don't even think they thought for half of this. They were just like, make trail with monsters on it. And then the designer was like, yeah, okay.
Yeah.
And he did that. I didn't even check to see where the states were. Alright, save is done, and I'm going to turn this off.
Did you change your, the game on Twitch?
Yeah, okay. Yeah, it's Quest 64 and more. And playing Quest 64.
It doesn't say it.
Oh. Hold on, I'm gonna update it again.
Let me see.
Okay.
It says Quest 64. Directory.
Alright, now you guys get to see the, intro.
Channel's live. I don't know why.
Quest 64, or as it's known in the, I think in the, European version it's called L-Tail? And
right.
Then in the other version, the original Japanese, it's called something else. It has three names. Just so you know, this game has three names. And this is the land of Keltland. And it's a crappy place that nobody likes. And you live in Kinnishire, which is the town that our hero Brian comes from.
What for what town? Whatever.
Yeah, it's crap town.
I can't even hear, like... It's like it's town, like, occasionally it just, like, pauses for, like, just a minute.
Yeah, hold on, let me... Alright, now it's paused because I've got it paused. Oh, okay.
Wow, this is Ireland. It looks exactly like Ireland.
Hmm? What?
I look at that because it looks like Ireland, except for there's a big lake in the middle.
Mm-hmm.
Bye.
Okay. Here we go. We got the game starting. And yes, I know that the artifacting is pretty distracting, but every ROM is like this. I downloaded two different ROMs from two different ROM sites that I trust, and it's like this. I think it's just the emulator and the way it displays the text in this game. Because it doesn't do this with Majora's Mask. So, I don't even know. I need to get an Ethernet cable. Oh, okay. Brian, even though I begged you not to leave, you still say you must go after your father.
Can't even see the game.
You can't see the game?
Glitching so hard.
Is it just like... Hold on. I'll refresh. Okay. Alright, it's cut up. Also, another thing, the music in this game kind of sucks as well. The only plus side to this game is the enemy designs. Just because it's impressive that they used, like, 3D models for enemies instead of just sprites or whatever. And that's not even very good.
Wow, it's way behind.
Hold on. Oh, okay. No matter how wonderful your powers may be, you are still a child. Father Lord Bartholomew, yes, Lord Bartholomew, left to search for the stolen Elltale book, and has been missing for a month.
A month. Wow.
Yeah, you want to know what this reminds me of? The beginning cutscene of, how the story begins for, Zelda, the Wand of Gamelon.
Oh, wow.
How it's like, the king goes out and he's like, I'm gonna defeat Ganon, and then he doesn't come back for 3 months or whatever, and they're like, oh,
yeah.
Let's go find him. This reminds me of that. And it's not a good thing. Contained in the words of the book is a power that exceeds human knowledge. I wonder who could have possibly stolen it from. Of course it's an evil dude. Can't wait to bomb Sotodongos. Yeah, me too. I'm so hungry I could eat an Octorok.
You know what? I like the really awful pink shade around the letters. It's like, that makes it even better.
Yeah. It just, it highlights the superior quality of this game.
Yeah, and
just,
it's
just makes it so much better.
Mm-hmm. It's almost like the writing, it's like, the font is like the equivalent of
it's equivalent to how the game plays, feels, acts, sounds,
yeah, mm-hmm.
and is.
Yep. So now you can, now your eyes can bleed from the font and from the story.
Yeah.
Oh boy.
All its cities will be destroyed, the spirit's blessings will disappear, and Keltland will be once again visited by a day of grief. Tholomy's disappearance may even mean he's cut. And the fighting over the book. In the fighting over... Oh, English. I did not catch this the first time. He's cut in the fighting. If you go, you may find yourself in danger as well. You still insist to begin by going to Dondoran. Alas, the king of Dondoran Castle to protect you. Alright. So yeah, we're going to freaking Dondoran, apparently. How do I leave? Oh, here's the door. Also, the perspectives, like, are just... The perspectives in this game are everyone's enemy. Fixed
right.
camera positions. And they look like Ireland and call it Keltland. Yeah. They just basically said, alright, let's make a super European game. What's European? Ireland is. Yeah, that's good. But we need to make it fantasy. We need to come up with a name for fantasy Ireland. Let's see, they have like shamrocks, nah. Clover? No. Celts. Let's just name it after a clothing item.
I read it as Celtland.
No, this is Keltland. Not Celtland whatsoever. Like, it's literally the land of Celts, despite I don't think anyone in this game as of yet has worn one. As you get close to a hidden spirit, you'll see a sign. When you see it, press the Z button. Mark of four spirits will appear. Press one of the Z buttons to choose which of the spirits you wish to increase. Need as much help for each of these spirits as you can get. But you can't get help for all the spirits, because by the end of the game, you won't be able to max out all of your magic levels. Because the way this game works. So yeah. Fire spirit. Basically, she's just telling you. All the NPCs in this game suck. There's no reason to talk to any of them. Even though sometimes you are required. Also note the stretched grass texture on these stairs. We have this weird center of this room, which is just has this little picket fence in the center. And a few strange changes with the lighting when you go around it. There. Walking into all, like, all these rooms, I fit into every- oh, whoops, I didn't really mean to walk into this. But all these rooms in this castle are meaningless, and they have nothing. Get out of this place. Leave now, Brian. In his last letter, Lord Bartholomew said that he crossed Loch Kildare, on the way to Larapool, okay. Be very cautious. Evil creatures lie in wait beyond these monastery walls. Now we have this music. I know the grass looks a little bit better here, but not by much. Just because they raised the brightness level where it doesn't look like spinach that someone just spread all over the ground. And here you get a nice perspective shot of the beautiful land of, the beautiful land of Keltland. The beautiful broccoli trees and asparagus grass.
Oh boy.
We also got this pretty decent looking horse. Which serves no purpose. You can't even ride it. And then we get this. Yet again. Where's the D-pad? Oh, here we go. Oh, wait, that's not working either. Where did I find the C stick? Oh, okay. Now we have one more power for that, even though it's not gonna matter. Oh, hold on. Also note this just tiny plant that looks like one of those tiny plants you'd see in a dungeon in Zelda. Right. Only somehow they made it look worse. Like, it just looks terrible, and it's just kind of there. It's not even grouped with any other tiny plants. It's just, yeah, and the stream is really
good
because I have it over to the side.
Yeah,
still...
I can't even, yeah, I'm like, you're talking about stuff and I can't even.
Yeah, apologies for that. It's not my fault that this thing is running Twitch down so much. Basically, at the part you're on, you get to watch me fiddle with the controls to figure out where the C sticks are mounted. Or the C pad, I should say. I'm kind of just waiting for the stream to catch up. But whatever. Alright, so right now I'm on a beach right now. You'll see it, but note how the water doesn't have any, different, particle effects when you go in it.
Right.
So it's like something they just forgot to do.
Yeah.
And then you have this, fisherman NPC. Halt, who goes there? Oh, it's you, laddie. Ever since your father went away, you've had to stand guard against the monsters that are surrounding our town. Lord Bartholomew was the spirit tamer, and we will not be safe until he returns. Every NPC is like that. just like nothing. They just say nothing. Now you have a very, like, Zelda-ish vibe from this. Just because the ground texture isn't so stretched and the tree textures look semi-decent. Except for the fact that they still aren't in 3D and, oh, I encountered strong enemies. These hellhounds are actually pretty decent in terms of overall design. But I do have to see some of the polygons on this creature look incredibly sloppy. Dewdrop obtained.
Don't know what the octagon thing is about.
Wait, where?
What?
What octagon thing?
The battle thing.
Oh, it's because, it's like, it basically, the octagon is how far you can move, and the, octagon surrounding the bell is the, I guess, battle line. If you cross it, then you can get out of the battle.
Right.
And that's the equivalent to running away. And except you actually have to, since the game is like an open world, turn-based. So basically, if you're far away from the enemy when it spawns, you have to just inch your way closer to them. And they have to do the same.
Mecha Chili says hello.
Oh, hey Mecha Chill. Chili. Yeah. Okay. I'm playing some excellent 64 games here and failing miserably at them. And
oh,
I cannot hit this thing for some reason. I'm pretty much dead. Like, I understand why people like this game. Like, because there are people who grew up with this game. And, like, for what it is as a beginner RPG, it's not that bad, but it's also just a beginner RPG. Like, it's for...
Right.
Yeah, it's like... You know, the RPG that introduces you to the way RPGs work, for the most part.
Right.
It's just it's got a very straightforward story.
Yeah, I can see, like, if you're, like, playing this...
as a kid, like, then this would actually, if I played this, like, I have games that are not necessarily good that I still love to this day, just because I played it a whole bunch as a kid. And a lot of them are licensed titles, so technically they're even worse than this. I personally don't like this game, Mecha Chili, but I didn't grow up playing it. But I could see why you like it. I could see why pretty much anyone would like this game, just because, I mean, to further its, I guess, flattery on it, there's no RPG games that work like, Quest 64 does on the 64. Like, this was technically the first 3D, full 3D RPG game for the 64. And thus it got a lot of hype.
Right.
So I'm gonna go ahead and heal at an inn. Oh, and this character right here, Shannon, she's like the Impa of this game, or something, or like, not the Impa, the Sheik of this game. Because she appears at these, little inns, like, pretty much every inn you go to, she appears. I think she stops appearing at a certain point, though. But she ends up being really important at the end of this game. Just out of the blue, she's like, oh, I'm important. And then the story's like, yeah, Shannon's important.
Mm-hmm.
Alright, so let's heal if I could get the camera to cooperate. Oh my gosh, can't even see what I'm doing.
I like the chunky graphics.
The character models and stuff?
I guess so.
Yeah, like, this character doesn't even have fingers. Their existence must be terrible. Like they literally just have these meat clubs as hands. You'll see the character soon enough.
How do they hold that thing?
Brian has, like, fists. But this character I'm talking to, Agnes, an innkeeper, apparently.
Right.
Like, this character has meat clubs as hands. I'm not even joking.
Oh,
like, literal freaking... It's just, it must be a miserable world.
It's like they just forgot to put...
Yeah, like, to put some kind of hand thing or, like, textures to make it look different. Yes. Do you know the Japanese version of his name is Jinjakface? Yeah. There's a lot of, like, this... It's so strange because this game had so many different name changes. Like, I mean, just, there's three different names for this game alone.
Apparently, also, one of the versions is, like, quite different. Like, all I know about. Apparently one of the versions of this game is quite different.
Yeah.
I don't know how, but...
How do I exit? Yes. Alright. Also, another thing... This game had the potential to be a heck of a lot better than it was. Like, I'm sure Mecha Chill probably knows this. But... Like, there was originally supposed to be three different playable characters. Ryan was going to be your mage. Then you were going to have a pirate guy who I forgot the name of. But he seemed pretty cool. And then you were going to have, like, a girl character, and I forgot what she does. But you can find this stuff out, you can find the screenshots and everything on Unseen 64. And it looked so much better. Like, Brian, I guess he's, you know, he's a character. Brian's definitely a character, I guess. But, like, just, I mean, playing the game...
I haven't even been paying attention to the story or whatnot.
Yeah. I mean, Brian's your Link character, but technically a little bit worse than Link, because, I mean,
right.
He's literally, his character trait at this point in the story is, I am chosen hero and I need to find Dad. And that's his character. But honestly, I think it would have been kind of cool to have the pirate guy in this game, just because, or heck, even the girl character, just because it'd be different characters, so you aren't forced to play as the mage. But it was cut due to time constraints, because this game had so much hype when it came out,
right,
that, like, it fell under the Sega trap of rushing games for Christmas or whatever. And so thus, you only got Brian. And also, I think there was a few cut areas, like, I'm pretty sure this is another thing Mechachill knows, but there's like a cave, a blue cave in this game, that has a blocked off end that never becomes not blocked off, yet it looks like it would. And that was originally supposed to be a part of the story where you had to open that cave, but now it's just like an empty area.
Right. Is the end still there?
Hmm? Yeah, the end of the cave is still there. It just doesn't have anything in it. Like, it's completely barren. It's like they made it, and then they were like, oh, time constraints. So
yeah,
they even fill it up.
Anything with it.
And just pretended like it was aesthetics or whatever.
Mm-hmm.
Rare rabbits. But once again, I gotta say the best thing about this game is just its enemy diversion. There's a spirit at the end of that path? Oh, so there is something there. I can't even remember how long it was that I read the article. I think it was... I don't even know. But yeah, apparently there is something there. Alright, but you can't even reach it, though. Like, it's just another overworld. Spirit things. And there's a lot of this, a lot of the overworld, like, if you see bubbles coming out of the ground in this game, and then that means there's a spirit, and you can... I mean, they're not bubbles, but that's what they look like.
Right.
But you can get another extra magic point without having to grind. Yeah. And this game also has a lot of things that it doesn't even tell you about. That it just kind of expects you to know. Or expects you to find on your own. But once again, like, I think the best thing about this game is just its enemy diversity. Like, I have screenshots of several of the enemies, because there's no enemy decks online that has pictures or anything. Because I guess no one cares enough about this game.
Yeah.
But the enemy diversity is pretty good. Like, there's a ton of different enemies. Even if some of them are just recolors, they're still different. Like, they aren't just blatant recolors, they added to their model or whatever.
Yeah.
So you gotta give them some credit for just enemies alone. Even if a lot of them are just your generic fair of, like, goblins and evil forest puppets.
Mm-hmm.
Giant plant.
Oh, so does you, Mechachilly, do you speedrun this game?
Hmm?
Can you hear me?
Oh, I can hear you.
Am I low?
Oh, no, you're actually pretty good. Like, it just cut off the end of that sentence. The last two lines. I think it's fine now. I'll speak again. Yeah, I used to. Ah, okay. That makes sense.
Yeah, I was asking if he spec speedrun.
Because you knew a lot about this game, so I figured.
Yeah.
So yeah, that's pretty cool. I'll have to say that another best thing about this game is the speedruns. Like, there was a point in time where I just watched speedruns of this game. Just because they're, like, it's weird how a game as, like, you know, typical as an RPG game as this is, has such interesting speedruns. But then again, there's a lot of games like that that are very run-of-the-mill fare, but they end up being really interesting to watch people do them fast. So
I think I remember
again.
I remember watching a speedrun of this after AGDQ 2013, I think.
I've watched AGDQ's speedrun of this. Yeah, I haven't seen the speedrun in a while though, because that marathon
Yeah, I wasn't even.
I don't even know most of their names, I'll be honest. Yeah, like I know there was two of them doing a race.
Mm-hmm.
I can't remember who won, but it was a lot of fun just to.
I remember it wasn't. I didn't even like. I just put it on to, like, have some noise, because AGDQ is a big event, and,
yeah.
You know, when it's over, you just go on to Speedruns Live and then just put stuff in for background noise, pretty much.
Mm.
And sometimes you get a little bit involved in it, but...
Yeah. Though I will say competitive speedruns do make things a little bit easier to pay attention to.
Yeah.
I'm gonna see if I can make it to this other town before I get off this or something. It's a lot better now, and there's an out-of-bounds clip, and a glitch that lets you dupe spirits. Oh, snap!
Gotta do that.
Yeah.
How do you do it?
Does it involve the spirit spots, or does it involve leveling up? Man, that sounds a lot better than the speedruns. Like, a lot of the speedruns, if I remember correctly, a lot of them are just, like, 2012, I think, is what a lot of them were dated.
Yeah.
If you just type in speedrun, any of the first results I've probably watched. But yeah.
Yeah, I remember, like... Mm-hmm.
Oh yeah, this is another thing that I don't like about this game. Due to the camera and stuff, it actually ends up like turning you around sometimes.
Quite a bit.
Yeah.
Yeah.
So you have to pay.
Then you end up walking backwards.
You exit or return on top of an overworld spirit. And during the cast animation, you're able to pick up the spirit multiple times.
Oh wow.
Oh wow. Well, I guess technically now you can get all of your magic levels maxed out on a normal playthrough. Because you can just stand there and, you know, just...
Yeah, now you gotta do it.
Yeah.
Where would you find one of those?
There's usually ones in the towns in the overworld. I probably missed several in the overworld because I wasn't paying attention. Is there one? No. Oh wait, there's a house over there. Also, this enemy is something I've never seen in a...
By the way, look at this scene right here.
Hmm?
Like, the ground is still very, bright, even if it's night.
Yeah. And it just, it looks kinda if. But then you have things like, another compliment to this game is the fact that the buildings don't look like they're smeared with molasses, and oh, here's a spirit. Okay.
Now, how do you do this? Cast exit or return on top of an overworld spirit.
Cast exit
or
return on top of an overworld spirit. 19 water to cast exit. Oh, so I'll have to... Alright. Yeah, it's not happening tonight. I think in the save, in the other save I have like 17 water or something.
Yeah.
I have my stats quite a bit.
What's water?
Yeah.
I don't even know what it is. Is that like your magic points or whatnot?
Yeah, basically the spirits are your magic. Collecting more spirits lets you unlock more magical powers that relate to that spirit. So for example, the earth spirits, which are the orange ones, allow you to throw bigger rocks the more you get.
Right.
And the wind ones allow you to throw like a bunch of gusts of wind that don't do a whole lot of damage, but they do a bunch of, I guess, comboing, because multiple wind gusts attack the enemy. The wind one, I find the, like, least use out of it. Just because, like, the fire one's pretty decent for certain enemies. The rock one's great. Yeah. And the water one is also great.
Mm-hmm.
But the wind is just something I've never really bothered. I'm just, like, avoiding all these enemies. Oh yeah, and speaking of rocks, even though rock is pretty good for Brian to use, if an enemy uses it, it's, like, the easiest attack to dodge. So you actually kind of want enemies to use rock attacks. Even though they do quite a bit of damage if you actually do get hit. Alright, let's speak to NPC guy. There's like a weird space between, like, this character's name is Curtis. And there, it looks like there's a full space between, like, the is part of Curtis. So it's like Kurt is.
Oh boy.
Farther along this road is Dondoran and the Connor Forest. Don't get careless in the woods. The robber is about. And this is the point of the game where all the NPCs talk about this robber all the time. Every NPC you talk to, like, has something either about the controls or about the robber. And literally, it's just like, hey, did you hear of that robber? Or, hey, you're that mage boy, right? Could you stop that robber? And it's literally that. And it's just, oh. Oh, wait, I got turned around. Did I? Oh, wait, I think I'm going the right way. So they're like Pokemon NPCs. Yeah! I mean, Pokemon NPCs have gotten better over the years. Especially in X and Y, which is surprising. But yeah, they're like Pokemon NPCs since of the Pixel games.
Yeah. All they talk about is just, like,
you're
the current,
like,
plot point.
You should go battle the gym leader. I hear he's pretty strong. Or,
yeah.
Have you been to a Pokemon recently? And it's like, stop it. I know about the gym leader, and don't tell me what to do. Unless it's story related, I won't do it. There we go. I'm afraid I've gotten turned around again or something. Like, the camera just, for some reason, focuses in on Brian's face after battles. So it just, wait a minute, is this the same house? Oh my gosh. But I will say about this enemy right here, This enemy is pretty original, considering it's literally just a fusion of a hippopotamus and a crocodile.
Right.
So I guess it kind of beat Mother 3 in its ridiculous chimeras.
Unbelievable.
Yeah. Alright, I think, yeah, if this, yeah, this is the same freaking house. Ugh. This is what I mean by, like, getting turned around. Just, like, stopped battling the enemies, even though that's unhealthy, but... Like, I'm not even really playing this game, I'm just showing it as an example. So I have a save going on right now, but... I think I saved over that on accident, so... But that might be gone. Please tell me this is a different house. If this is the same freaking house, I'm just gonna stop playing right here.
You're going in circles.
Yeah. This was what it was like in the Connor Forest. Like, had I streamed this while I was in the Connor Forest area, even with the save states and everything, because I was being lazy,
right.
Like, it was the same thing. The Connor Forest is, like, it has two branching things. It has, like, a shortcut thing over to one side. Freaking joking. How? Alright, guess what, guys? This is the same house. Anyways. But the Connor Forest was technically worse than this. In terms of how many times I got turned around in that place. And all of the vegetation looks similar because it's basically just a vegetation maze.
Right.
But yeah. Right, so here's the sign. Coming across the sign. We're approaching the sign. And the Connor Forest is over there, so here's Dondurand. Get to the door of the castle. Alright. This town, I guess, is decently designed. It's probably the best designed town out of all of them, but that's not saying much. It's an extremely small town. And even still, I get turned around in this place. Oh. Oh man. More unfortunate NPCs with them. Like. Terrible hands. There was like a.
I noticed all the textures are like pixel art.
Yeah.
Rather than needed.
Yeah, like these trees right here aren't drawn, they're pixel, and then they smeared molasses filter over it.
Yeah.
Though I will say, where this really shines is the clearness of the wood textures, some of them. And also, certain brick textures look really good. But other times it just looks like your typical 64 fare. I'm making my way down to the sea, but... Apparently I'm lost again in this tiny town. Oh, here we go. And here you have two NPCs that are talking about... guess who? Even the king is worried about the robber. I heard he even sneaked into the castle.
Oh
no one
God.
Knows when the robber might come back again. And this is another meat club arm lady. Have you seen Princess Flora? She's a tomboy and is always getting into mischief, exactly like the late queen when she was young. Bet she'll turn into a real beauty in time. And then there's like characters who talk about people we don't even know. Like, we just walked into this town and talked to these persons, and we have no idea who Princess Flora is. And it's not even the same thing as, like, some NPCs in other games, like, giving you hints on locations or giving you hints on characters. Like, they just bring up a character or a location, and you're like, what are you talking about? Where is that? Did I miss something important? Am I missing exposition? Castle of Dondurin. We're going to get a quest from King something. Scott Fort is the name of this guy. King Scott Fort. So you're the master apprentice the Grand Abbot has written about. Welcome to Dondurin. I know you're searching for your father, Lord Bartholomew, who is missing on his quest for the Ale Tale book. That's the reason why in the European version it's called Ale Tale. Or was it the Japanese version or something? I don't know. I keep forgetting. That did remind me of the third name of this. It was called, like, Holy Quest or something like that. It was the third name of this.
Yeah, I think so. I don't even know, though. I don't think so.
Or the Brazen Thief Who Stole the Earth Orb. My secret treasury. Blah blah blah. Get the thing. And oh, I clicked on him. Like, just it's just babbling on and on. All right. And then the rest of the people in this castle don't actually matter. So talking to them is useless. Oh my gosh. Probably gonna stop playing this soon.
Yeah, it's already midnight.
Yeah. Let me quit and go back to the save I was on and see.
Okay.
Whether or not I accidentally wiped it. Kinda hoping I did it, but at the same time, it doesn't really matter. THQ. Oh, speaking of which, they're now defunct.
Yeah.
Like, I have so many games that I own that are by THQ, and every time their logo comes up, like, I'm instantly reminded, oh wait, they're dead.
Mm-hmm.
I have 12. Okay, I'm here. Okay. So I guess I don't even know what level I was when I stopped. Alright, So let's see what kind of enemies they have in store for this area, because the enemies here are tough. So I was grinding the last time.
Is this the same area?
This is the same area as the first time I launched this game today.
Yeah.
So yeah, it's not the same area as I was. Like I'm not at Dondoran. I'm way past Dondoran. I already beat the thief guy. I guess another thing in this game that makes it a little bit more bearable is that you don't have to worry about magic potions, really, because you have, like, spells that can get magic back, and you can also walk to replenish magic.
Great.
I can get on this road before I die by enemies, because I've literally only got to pass this bridge. Also, one enemy in this game that's in one of the cave areas, and I think it actually appears in several cave areas,
right.
That literally looks like the Pokemon Golduck's head, but just like it's just its head with arms and legs, and it's also black and brooding looking, and it literally looks like that. Like, I mean, it even has a duck beak kind of thing going on. I don't think I'm gonna be seeing that anytime soon here, though. Gremlins. Let's see what kind of magic. I think that's the first time I've seen an enemy like up its own stats. Oh my gosh. I'm gonna need to throw rocks at these things, I think. I never figured out the typing strategy and whatnot.
I'm sorry I'm not talking that much.
I'm not talking either, just because, I mean, there's not even really anything to talk about here.
Yeah, it's about time we switch over.
Yeah. We just finished beating up these guys and see how far I can walk before I die. Which is probably not far. I'm actually just gonna try and run from these guys.
You know what I hate about RPG, or at least RPGs like this, where you have a big attack and it clearly shows it as hitting them.
Yeah, and then it says
then
miss.
Miss. Mhm.
Even though it makes the hit sound and everything, Yeah, and you can see that. It hitting. It's just.
It's ridiculous.
Yeah. Alright, it says N over here, I think. We're still getting, like, small enemies like these. Oh, snap! Here we got some hardcore enemies. Ghost hounds. Aw, man, those look way cooler than the hellhounds. Except for the fact that I have green, and I can't ungreen it. Oh, here we go. Oh, missed it.
I need to get a soundboard.
Yeah.
Boring fast.
Yeah. As I said, that's probably why I'm definitely not gonna play that again. If not as just like a massive joke stream. Yeah, see if I can speed run it without knowing.
Yeah, that would be pretty funny.
Blind speed run.